Hey guys, so welcome. We'll be talking about the 10 things never to do online, and so there are so many things you should never even try to do online because these things you might do can jeopardize so many things, either presently or in future. So we'll be telling you, I'll be giving you the top 10 things never to do online. So we'll be right back. Welcome to CYBERSAFE. I'm Women Imanu. If you're new to this channel, click on the subscribe button and also the notification bell icon to get updates from us when we upload. And so this channel, we talk more on online safety. We give you cybersecurity information on how you can stay safe online, how you can be protected online. So we give you those tips, those details. So if you like that, click on the subscribe button and then enjoy this video. So the 10th one on the list of things never to do online. Never click on links that specify you download something without confirming that it is safe to download first before downloading. You can use online scanning tools to make sure you scan the links. You can scan links. So for example, there's virustotal.com. I'll put the link in the description below. You can use virustotal. You can use NoDistribute. There are so many online platforms you can use to scan links to make sure they are safe or they've not been previously reported as a phishing website or a scam website. So you make sure you scan the link. So before you download any zip folder, like so many music albums are coming out, so many movies to download are zipped, especially zipped files. So make sure you scan the link to download. If you're using your phone, you can hold it down. You will see copy link to download. Then go to the website virustotal.com. Then you paste it there. You scan the link to make sure it is safe. Then before downloading, if it is not safe, you will see past comments of what people have said about the website. So make sure you scan. It is very, very important to scan any link you are getting online. Don't just rush to download from that link, okay? Because you could be downloading malware or viruses or any other things into your phone, your mobile phone or your system or your computer system, whatever it is. So be careful about that. Then the 9th one on the list of things never to do online. Never assume you are familiar with anyone online. Okay, so sometimes people use different social media platforms. Okay, for example, on Facebook, you could get a friend request from someone that you think you know. Okay, so the person might have the picture of a friend that you once knew or the name, exact name, because now on social media platform, different social media platforms, either on Instagram, on Facebook, on Twitter, people can just decide to use any name they want to use. People can impersonate basically and use the picture, use the exact same thing. So don't be deceived. It might not be the person you are talking to. So most times you be cautious in the info you give out, and then you can always even ask the person certain questions you feel the person should know if the person is your friend. Try when the person sending friend suggestions. So don't be quick to give out information, or don't be quick to assume you are familiar with this person, that because this person has this picture, that yes, this is the person. So always confirm. We don't be in a hurry to assume that the person is someone you know. The number 8 on this list, never use the same password on all social media platform or on all platforms. Okay, so you have your mail. Some people, for their emails, their Facebook account, their Twitter account, or any account on Facebook, their PayPal account, any account, they are using the same password. And what happens in this case is that if, for example, PayPal is breached and they get the passwords or some details on PayPal or on Facebook or any platform, it can be, though some of these platforms, they have all this hashing, what they call hashing. You might not know what it is, but some of those, your passwords might be protected. But in case of breaches, or in case you are social engineered, or somehow your password is gotten in one platform, and if you're using the same password in other platforms, it can be jeopardized in a way that once they've gotten one in one platform, they can access your other accounts in different other platforms. So be careful. Make sure you use different passwords. Yes, it might not be easy to put all those different passwords in your head, especially when they are strong passwords. When I mean by strong password, I mean passwords that contain capital letters, small letters, special characters, and numbers. If your password does not contain those 4 characters, you should know that your password is not strong. So, and your password should be longer than 10 digits. It should be as long as 10. Okay. So then sometimes it might be on over 20 social media platforms or 20 different platforms where you use password, mails, or e-commerce sites, social media sites, different platforms, and then you wonder, how can I keep all those different passwords, over 20 in my head, when they have strong passwords. So you don't need to do that. They are what they call password managers. They are certified password managers online. So you can get some on your Play Store. I'll put a link in the description below of one that I know it's okay. I'm not advertising for them. I know that one is okay. So you can use that particular one. If you go to your Play Store, you see that it is certified and it is one of the most used ones, okay? So you make sure you use password manager if you cannot keep everything in your head, but sometimes you can keep some in your head. It's actually okay. So, but never write the passwords down for any reason. It's better you use the password manager or use something that you can always remember. Use something that you can remember, okay? So never write them down and never give someone your password. So it's still under this point. Never ever give anyone your password and never use the same password on different platforms. It's not advisable. The number 7 on the list of things never to do online: never ever connect to a public Wi-Fi while accessing your bank applications or e-commerce sites where you put sensitive data like your card details and so on. Because if you visit a public Wi-Fi, if you use a public Wi-Fi, your details could be collected, because there are some people that could monitor what you do on those public Wi-Fi. So the people that set it, even the people that do not, even if it is someone that did not set the public Wi-Fi, your data can be monitored. So people can monitor what you do, monitor the website you visit, get some details that some important details from you. So make sure you don't connect to public Wi-Fi. If you want to connect to a public Wi-Fi, make sure you are only either updating, you can update your apps using public Wi-Fi, okay? That is okay, but you should not do any other thing. Don't visit your bank account details with a public Wi-Fi. Public Wi-Fi are usually not safe, especially the ones you don't know, okay? So they could be tampered with. So, but if you are to use a public Wi-Fi, make sure you use a good VPN, okay? And sometimes most of these VPNs, a VPN means virtual private network, so it makes everything you are doing encrypted. So your details will not be in the clear. Whatever you are typing in cannot be seen by anyone monitoring the traffic. So you can use a VPN if you want to access all those things, because it encrypts your data and whatever you are doing. But you need to be, it's not any VPN. Most free VPNs don't really do a good job. So it's mostly the paid ones that can do a good job in terms of encryption. So in my later videos, I will explain the best free VPNs and then the best paid ones, so that you can know the VPN to subscribe to, okay? So, but before, do not connect to public Wi-Fi without having your VPN enabled. So it's better that way. So if you don't have a VPN that is trusted, do not connect to a public Wi-Fi. It is not safe. Never post things online that will haunt you later in the future. Okay, so what do I mean by this? Sometimes people go online and they post different type of pictures, or some people even go ahead insulting people and doing so many things. And some people have forgotten that the internet really never forgets. So whatever you delete is still stored somewhere online. Okay, so you might post something insulting to someone or to an organization or somehow, and then this thing that you put can easily be screenshot by someone. Someone could screenshot it, or it's saved permanently. So even if you delete it online and you think it's gone forever, it is not gone. Okay, so there are different websites that can be used to get these details back or get what you originally posted before deleting it. So don't think whatever I posted and then deleted is finally gone. It is not entirely gone. It is just not visible for the normal viewing, but could be gotten somehow through a backdoor. Okay, so never post things that will haunt you later in the future. So if you, because most times all the people looking for jobs, and so in the future, if you are looking for a job or sometime, let me not use in the future, so that it's not look far-fetched or far away. Okay, so you might be looking for a job, and then most of these people you might not know. Especially if you use LinkedIn, so a platform like LinkedIn, you see where they go through your profile. You might just notice someone has gone through your profile, or even on Facebook, other platforms, they might go and then check what you've been up to so far, or they just know the type of person you are, basically. So if you're always fond of insulting people or posting things that are ridiculous, basically, let me use that word. So if you know you're the type of person that will probably look for office jobs or something like that, be careful of what you post online, because they can always be gotten. They are never forgotten, okay? So they can always come back to haunt you. Be careful of what you post online. Never post things online that can haunt you. So the fifth thing, never to do online. Never discuss a company or organizational details with friends. Okay, so there are details that or things that happen in the company or organization that are supposed to be confidential, and so you are not supposed to be online, or you are not supposed to tell people about it. So be careful never to do such. Okay, so people that do such, most times either they get implicated and then they end up having issues with the company. So never tell, never post confidential issues online. It is important you don't do that. The fourth thing never to do online, this one too is very important. This one is very important. Never ignore an application update notification. Okay, so you might get notification from your app store saying update your WhatsApp, update this particular application. Make sure you update it. Find time to update it. It's important you update this app. There are reasons why new updates are rolled in weekly, sometimes monthly. Okay, so it's because sometimes vulnerabilities must have been found in these applications that could be used to exploit you. So if they put out updates, it means it's important you do so. Okay, either to make sure the app is working better if it was not responsive before, or to close any vulnerability that was once in the application. So make sure you update it. It is very, very important you update your apps. The third thing never to do online, never post your portfolio online. Like that, some things, details about yourself that you don't post online just publicly, because there are some important details that could be used to, like your email. Sometimes you are not supposed to just post it online, because through that avenue you can get spam mails, phishing mails, and so many other things. So aside the email, sometimes you can, but most times you just need to be careful with the kind of details you give out online. And then be careful of taking random quizzes online. So you might see a quiz saying fill this, fill your details, put your name, whatever, your best color, stuff like that. So you see random quizzes that you think, okay, it's just a quiz now, let me answer it. Sometimes they are used to collect data, and all this data could be used against you in a way. So I'm not saying all these things so that you get scared or you're paranoid. Just be careful. That's just the main thing. Be careful. Don't just give details anyhow. Confirm the details you are giving. Make sure it's not something that can be used to harm you or hurt you later in the future. So be careful of the details you put online. Never put important details or about you online. It's not safe. So the number two on the list of things never to do online, make sure you don't post information or don't spread information that has not been verified. Okay, because most times when there are some places that they have laws that if you post false information, you could be either you are sued, someone could decide to pick you up and then sue you for something you never knew about, but because you forwarded a particular message you're not sure about, or something controversial. Okay, but if you are trying to share an information, it's fine, but maybe political news or something controversial. So don't just share anything, any news that has not been confirmed. Don't share news that has not been confirmed. Make sure it's something that has been confirmed, or just irregular information that will not hurt anyone. Don't be careful of the information you forward or you share. Okay, so make sure it's something credible. Make sure it's an information that is credible before you share it. Don't rush to share any information you're not sure of because your friend sent it to you. Because on WhatsApp or other platforms, you see someone sending send a link with one nonsense detail saying you get free iPhone, free this, and person sends links and says send it to 10 of your friends. You are sending a link to 10 of your friends. Most of these people, they don't know about, they are not cyber security safe, and these links could be phishing links. So by the time you are innocently sending this thing and you don't know what it is, so the moment you send it, the person could click the link, your friend could click the link, and so when your friend clicks this link, your friend might fall into the traps of those that sends the phishing link in the first place. You might not have clicked the link, but by the time you forward it to over 10 people, at least 4 or 5 of them might click the link, and if it's something malicious, if it's a phishing link, they will get affected, and then they might blame you in the end. So be careful of the things you send. It's not everything you see that they will say forward to your contact. It's not everything you forward. Make sure it's something credible or something certified. Don't just send anything anyhow. Okay, so the first and most important one, I can't stress this one enough. never ignore setting up two-factor authentication. Okay, so you might, when you, most times they always ask you your Gmail, your Facebook, your Instagram, whatever, always ask you to enable two-factor authentication. I purposely left this one to the number one spot because it's very important. Any platform you are on, any social media platform, be it YouTube, WhatsApp, anywhere, once the platform has that two-factor authentication, enable it, please. I can't stress it enough because there was a YouTube creator that his account was hacked because your Gmail is linked to your YouTube account. So his Gmail was hacked, his password was gotten, and like that, they deleted all his contents. Okay, so you could have easily prevented that by enabling two-factor authentication. The way two-factor authentication works is that even if someone has your password, the person got your password one way or the other, either it was leaked or somehow the person got your password, the person cannot access your account unless the person has your mobile phone, because the person must be able to get the PIN that they sent to your mobile phone to be able to. It's like adding an extra layer of security. So even if the person types in your password, the person will need to type in a PIN or something that is going to be sent to your account before the person can really access your account. So even if the person has a password, it is useless to the person. So make sure you enable two-factor authentication. It's very, very, very important you do so. Don't skip it. If you see where you are asked to do it, don't skip it. Enable it. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you've not subscribed, click on the red subscribe button below and also the notification bell icon to get notifications from us when we upload new content, okay? And give us a thumbs up if you like this video. So question of the day, how many of these things have you been doing before, and has anyone ever affected you? So drop your comments in the comment section below and let's hear more about it. So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe. We'll see you next time. Goodbye. Does the beat take you over? You just can't breathe. Do you feel your bones start to shake? Do you feel the earthquake?